All right. Let's see what we got here.
Oh, you're gonna have to tip it more.
Yeah, there we go.
I don't have to put my phone on. Vibrate.
Yeah, good point there. Good call, Paradise.
Hey, baby daddy's doing a live interview on the TV, so I'm gonna have to call you back. All right.
All right, it's low. Okay, fine. Hey, this is Flying Monkey. We're here with Paradise Gray from Paradise the Architect, one of the founders of X-Clan. Does a lot of work in TAN with pretty much every cause you'd want to name in the African-American community. Justice for Jordan Miles, anti-gun stuff, lots of community building. And he works with Jaziri X producing videos. So we've just invited him to sit down and talk to us about what's going on.
Hey, cooler, man. You know, loving that finally the whole country and the whole world are finally waking up to see what's going on. I love being a part of the movement that's snatching the curtain off Oz.
Yeah, that's it, isn't it? It's been amazing watching it come to Pittsburgh. Did you see it on the first day when they were here?
Of course. I met with the people at the Freedom Corner, and I marched from Freedom Corner all down to Market Square, and you know, Jaziri did a live mic check with the new version of the Occupy We the 99 song, and you know, we've been fellowshipping and breaking bread and spending time with the great heroes that are down here at the encampment now. Occupy, baby.
Occupy. I'm hoping we're going to be okay with this video. I'm like, alright, maybe we should turn around.
Yeah, maybe. Hold on, we're going to be right back after we turn around so we don't get drowned out by this generator.
Actually, we can walk with this, Paradise.
True that, true that.
Let's just walk with it.
We don't have to watch that.
Right? Yeah, I would watch it.
Yeah, watch it.
Alright.
Yeah, let's just go down.
All right.
Yeah, we're going to take a little tour right now.
All right,
this is Occupy Pittsburgh coming to you live from the PGH. You know, the real Pirates and Steelers in Pittsburgh is Carnegie and Mellon. You know what I'm saying? Look around. All these beautiful new skyscrapers. But yet we have the poorest black community in America right here in Pittsburgh, PA. You know, they'll tell you that Pittsburgh is the model city for economic redevelopment and how after the steel mills crashed, how Pittsburgh was one of those cities that pulled up its bootstraps and everything is economically wonderful. We have CMU producing robots. We have all this new technology coming out of Pittsburgh. Pittsburgh is one of the greenest cities with the new Green Convention Center. But in spite of all of that and the fact that they're calling Pittsburgh America's most livable city, Pittsburgh still remains almost unlivable for people who live in the black community, for people of color. You know, so this Occupy movement is very much a black issue. This is not just a movement for young white liberals. This movement means everything to our elders in our community whose social security is being threatened, whose livelihood is being threatened, and also Pittsburgh's black community has always been a hard-working community. You know, we haven't always had high levels of unemployment. You know, from the coal mines to the steel mills, Pittsburgh's black elders have historically been some of the hardest working people in the world. But you have a situation now where the only jobs available for young people or our elders are very low-paying jobs that don't pay a living wage. So you have all these incredible people who are capable of doing the work who can't find jobs, and the jobs that are available are Walmart and, you know, service jobs, you know, small jobs that are not paying people the kind of money that it takes so that you can afford to raise a family, you know, on your salary, you know, and once you pay for healthcare, if you're lucky enough to get healthcare from one of these companies, you barely have enough money for medicine or food at the end of the day. So We're here to occupy Pittsburgh, occupy the world, occupy hip-hop, and let everybody in the world know that these are our issues. We do have issues. There are a lot of things going on in the world that we need to address.
So, Paradise, do you think more people from the African community are going to come down and support this now it's kind of established and safe? Because you heard, like, the Mellon gave us permission to stay indefinitely. Mm-hmm. As you can see, it's not like New York. We're not surrounded by cops here. It seems pretty safe for the moment, you know?
Absolutely. Well, I'm hoping that the black community comes out. We have to do a better job at informing the black community and everybody about the issues that affect us, you know? Just to be vague and say that, oh, we're against Wall Street and the people that work on Wall Street, the brokers, it's not about that. You know, it's a whole economic issue that 99% of the people are being ripped off while 1% of the people are the ones who are continue to get richer. But we've never had an American dream. All we've ever had is America's nightmare. You know what I'm saying? So income equity is something that's very much at stake in this for us.
Yeah. So what is this? You've seen a lot of stuff in your life. What does this kind of setup remind you of?
The only thing I could think of that this reminds me of the days when I was born, the 60s. You know what I'm saying? America hasn't seen anything like this since then. And I got all this gray hair, but I was born in 1964. But I remember seeing the famous pictures that world-famous photographers and any student of history will remember